and thanks for coming back. In our interaction supervisor video series, we've been walking through a 7-course lesson to feast. And in today's video, we've reached the main course, the pizza. You know, when you have a pizza party for your agents, some like those plain, some like those loaded, some are in between. For many of you, looking at the data for your call center is much the same. Some of you like the plain reports straight out of the box. Some of you like complex reports loaded with numbers and cross tabs. And some of you are in between. Today, we're going to take a look at how to run those reports using an agent supervisor.
Here is the Historical Reports tab open in Interaction Supervisor. Our focus here is to show you how to create and run reports. If you are wondering which reports to run, check out our video called Top 6 Interactive Intelligence Call Center Reports, a video guide. In that video, I discuss the reports I think are most important for every call center leader to use. One of the reports I discuss in that earlier video is called Queue Period Statistics Response Report Accumulative Percentage. Catchy name, don't you think? This is the report we're going to run first. Notice in the Historical Reports view, the default is to sort the reports by category. Scroll down to the section of Queue Reports and locate the report with the long name. Well, they all have long names, but you can see what I mean right here. Double-click on the name of the report, and the Report Parameters dialog comes up. Let's start by selecting the queues we want displayed in the report. Type the name of each group you want included. You need to type these names exactly the way they are configured in the system. Separate the names with a semicolon. If you leave !!ZZZ in the selection field, you will pull data for all queues. Now, notice the tab on the top called Date, Time, Range. Clicking on this tab, you'll see the fields where you can designate which days and time you want included in the report. If you run the report at this point with no changes, you'll get data from midnight to the current point of today. To change the date and times for the report, you can manually edit the range displayed in the first field, or you can customize the list of ranges included in the bottom section. Delete the row in the bottom section, type in the new date and time in the appropriate fields, and click Add. When you click Run, the report will be created and displayed for you. I want to point out two things from here. First, the tree on the left side of the report display is very helpful to navigate a long report. You can click on a selection within the tree, and the page containing that data will be displayed. Also, from this point in the system, you can export the data to a variety of formats. Click on the envelope icon on the top row. A drop-down list is presented with the various export options, including both PDF and spreadsheets. There are lots of other features available in running your reports. I recommend you jump in and start running reports to see what's in there. If you need help, contact your system administrator or your interactive intelligence partner. That's what we're here for. I'm heading back for another slice of pizza. We'll see you again soon.